Today we're gonna talk about expert web design secrets that can actually double your sales. Did you know that 38% of people will stop engaging with a website if they think the content or layout is unattractive? Because over the years I've analyzed but also built hundreds of websites. So these are not just theories but actually proven strategies that I've seen successful businesses use. And I call these the 7 golden rules of web design for sales. Rule number one, make it easy to use. Think of your website as a physical store. Make it a place where customers enjoy spending their time. And so what can you actually do to improve this? Keep the navigation simple. You should have no more than 5 to 7 main menu items. Group similar items together. Put related products or information in the same place. Use easy to read text. There is this whole debate on the internet which font is best for which use case, but to make it simple, make sure that the text is big enough. I recommend 16 pixels as the minimum size for text. Next, leave some empty space. Don't cram everything together because empty space helps make important things stand out. Your website is a website and not a brochure. And also make information easy to scan. Use headings, subheadings, or cards to separate texts. Bonus tip, ask real people to test your website, watch how they use it and listen to their feedback. One of the easiest ways to make a great website. Golden rule number two, make it attractive. People understand pictures much faster than words. Use this to grab attention and explain things quickly. So how to actually implement this? Use high quality photos. This should be obvious, but I still see so many sites that don't do it. And if you show a product, show it from all angles and not just from the front. Create short videos, ideally under 2 minutes, that show how your product works, or a video from a happy customer, like a video testimonial. Use pictures to explain information. This is one of the greatest powers that we designers have, that we can turn complex information into easy to understand visuals. Also important, keep your look consistent. Use the same colors, fonts, and styles across your whole website, because otherwise it just gets really confusing. And now this is also really great. Use small pictures or icons to explain things quickly. Now a lot of the time you can replace some words with small, easy to understand icons, and it just makes your site so much more alive and more easy to understand. Pro tip, make your website load faster by using a trick called lazy loading. This means pictures only load when the user scrolls down to see them. Golden rule number three, make it work well on phones. More than half of all website visitors use phones, which means your site must look good on small screens. Now how to do that? First one's obvious, make your site responsive. This means that your website should automatically adjust to fit any screen size. Make buttons easy to tap. So buttons should have like a minimum size of 40 pixels on phones, and also there should be a gap between different buttons so they don't tap on the wrong thing, which can be really frustrating. Also keep forms simple on phones. They shouldn't be too long or too complicated, and make them in a way that users can automatically fill in fields if they have the functionality enabled. Also add phone friendly features. For example, when you have a telephone number on your website, make it tappable so people can just instantly call the number instead of copy pasting it. Pro tip, there's a free tool by Google that lets you check if your website is phone friendly, and I recommend checking it out. Golden rule number four, make it fast. If your website is just 1 second slower, you can already lose 7% of your sales. So how to prevent this? Make your images smaller. There are a lot of free tools that you can use to reduce image sizes, and like a general guideline is to keep it below 200 kilobytes. Also go easy on the animations. If you create a site that is really heavily animated, it can really slow down the website speed because the browser has to load all the JavaScript and everything, and it will just make your site slower. Also another big trick is not to load super big videos on your site directly. You can use other services like Vimeo, YouTube, or something to embed your videos, but don't load them directly onto your site. Pro tip, another Google tool that is helpful is PageSpeed Insights, where you can check your performance, and this is a really great way to see if your site is performing well. And by the way, if you found these tips helpful so far, consider subscribing for more content like this. So, golden rule number five, make them want to click. Your call to action buttons or CTAs guide your visitors to buy. Make them stand out and sound exciting. Maybe this is obvious, but make your buttons a different color than the rest of your site. Write exciting but clear button text. So instead of just saying submit, use something like start free trial or book a call. And next, put buttons where people can actually see them. Place important buttons at the top of the page. And if you're building a long page, repeat buttons as people scroll down. You can also use something like a sticky button and also create a sense of urgency. You can use phrases like "only 3 spots left" to show visitors that you only have limited supply. Actually, a really interesting advanced technique is to show different buttons to returning customers and new customers. This technique is called smart CTA. So rule number 6 is to build trust. And generally, people trust people more than they trust companies. So use this to your advantage to show that your business is trustworthy. How can you do that? Show customer reviews. Put reviews on your product pages, include customer photos and if possible full names, because it makes the testimonials seem more trustworthy. Also, share detailed customer stories. Feature longer stories from happy customers. Especially powerful are video stories. Display trust symbols. Especially on sites where people provide payment info, it's great to have like certain kinds of certificates that people know that they are on a trustworthy site. For example, you can also include logos of well-known companies that relate to you or that you have worked with to increase the trust on your website. And also show real-time activity. Some sites do that they add like small pop-ups that you see that this product is currently being viewed or even bought by so and so many people. And so you can add certain elements to show that your site is active and that it's popular. Pro tip. So what I think is a really interesting tool is Zendja. Don't know if it's pronounced like that, but it's basically a tool where you can collect and show customer reviews or testimonials. You can also use something like Trustpilot, but these tools help to really build and show your testimonials in a great way. And now golden rule number 7, test and improve. Your website can always get better. Use data to keep improving. So how can you actually test your website? First, you need to choose important pages to test. Focus on pages that get a lot of visitors or are very crucial for your sales. This could be your homepage or product page. When testing, only change one thing at a time. For example, the main headline or one of the main images. You can also use so-called heat map tools. And so these tools help you show where people click and how far they scroll. Tools like Hotjar can help you with this. And so once you've tested, it's important to look at your website data. Regularly check things like how many people leave the site early, how long they stay, and of course how many people actually buy or click on the main CTA. And then look for ways to improve on these numbers. Before you start a test, ask yourself, what does success look like? Do you want more clicks, fewer people leaving, or actually just more sales? You can use Google Optimize for free testing, which actually integrates into the Google Analytics suite, but there are also other interesting tools that you can use like Matomo or Posthoc. Remember, following these rules is an ongoing process. Keep working on your website bit by bit, and after a while, the results can be amazing for your sales and business growth. And so there you have it. 7 golden rules that can turn your website into a sales machine. Make it easy to use, make it attractive, make it work well on phones, make it fast, make them want to click, build trust, and lastly, test and improve. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, consider subscribing for more tips on improving your web presence. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.